Dear students, today I am going to discuss Unit 2 Commercial Mathematics, Chapter 2 Compound Interest of Class 9. So in this chapter, first I want to discuss about money. So money is very essential for our daily life, isn't it? Sometimes what happens during some emergency cases, we don't have sufficient money in our home or in our bank deposits. In that case, what we will do? We will borrow money from other people, or if any amount is there in the bank or in insurance companies, we will withdraw that money, isn't it? So we have deposited the money, and in some cases, what we will do? We will withdraw the money for our emergency use. So this business is going on. So this business comes under the topic commercial mathematics. Borrowing and lending the money. Borrowing and lending the money. So already in the previous classes, we have discussed about this topic. So today I want to revise what are the terms used when we are calculating the interest. First, I want to discuss principal or sum. So, what is meant by principal or sum? The money borrowed or lent out for certain period of time is called principal or sum. That means money is borrowed from person or from bank for certain period of time, or 1 year or 2 years, etc. is called, that money what you borrow is called as sum or principal. For example, I borrowed 10,000 rupees from a person, or I borrowed some lakhs, 1 lakh or 2 lakhs from the bank. That amount is nothing but, money is nothing but principal or sum. Second is interest. So interest means what? So when I am borrowing the money from a lender, I am giving some extra money along with the borrowed money, because I am using the money of that person for my work. So therefore, that extra money what I am paying for the lender is called interest. So extra money paid for using others' money is called interest. Understood? Now we come to the third definition, amount. So what is meant by amount? So amount is nothing but it is the sum of principal and interest after a specified period is called the amount. For example, 10,000 rupees I borrowed from a person or from a bank or from a post office. I will make an agreement with the particular person or a bank. After 2 years, I want to give back what money I borrowed from that particular institution. So what they will do is, they will put some interest on that. So what, at the end of the 2 years, so what I should do? I should give the principal amount and the interest to the particular institution. Maybe it may be a person, or it may be a bank, or it may be a post office, or it may be insurance office. That is called as amount. So principal along with the interest, that sum of principal along with the interest is called amount that you have to give for. What is rate? So rate is nothing but interest on rupees 100 for 1 year is called rate percent per annum. For 100 rupees for 1 year, what is the interest they are paying? That interest is nothing but interest on rupees 100 for 1 year is called rate percent or rate per annum. Per annum is per year. That is called as rate. So what next term is, what is meant by time? The period for which money is borrowed is called time. So for example, for 2 years, I make an agreement with the particular commercial institutions. So I will give back the amount after 2 years, or I will deposit in the bank the amount for 2 years or 3 years. That period is called that period, what period I am keeping the money or I am borrowing the money from the bank or any other institutions is called as, that period of for which I am keeping money is borrowed is called as time. Now I told already, interest means it is the extra money I am paying for the money lender is called interest, because I am using the money of that particular money lender. So interest are of two types. One is simple interest, second one is compound interest. So in the last class, in the 8th standard, we discussed about what is simple interest, isn't it? So what is meant by simple interest? When money is borrowed on simple interest, then interest is calculated uniformly on the original principal throughout the period. For example, I borrowed 10,000 rupees, okay, for 2 years time, 5% interest. So what happens at the end of the 2 years, interest will be calculated for the original principal only. So original principal is what? 10,000 rupees. For 10,000 rupees only, they will calculate the interest. So uniform interest. For whatever it may be, maybe 3 years or 4 years, if you borrow the money also, the principal will never change. Principal, they will take only from the original principal only. They will take original principal. That only it is saying here. When money is borrowed on simple interest, then interest is calculated uniformly on the original principal throughout the period. So what is the formula we are using for the simple interest? Simple interest is equal to PTR by 100. P means principal, T means time, R means rate of interest, and whole divided by upon 100 is the formula to find the simple interest. So understood now? So what we discussed here, what are the terms we are using in the commercial mathematics, especially in case of taking the money or depositing the money, borrowing the money or giving the or depositing the money in any business institutions. So principal means it is the money borrowed or lent out for a certain period of time is called principal. Interest means extra money we are paying for the for using the money of that person. We are giving extra money because we are using the money of that person or institution. Amount means the sum of principal and interest after a specified period is called the amount what we are getting at the end of the loan period. What we are getting is nothing but an amount. Rate means what? Interest on rupees 100. For 1 year, it's called rate percent per annum. Time means the period for which money is borrowed is called time. Simple interest means money is borrowed on simple interest means interest will be calculated uniformly on the original principal throughout the loan period. That is called as simple interest. So what is the formula we are using to find out the simple interest? Simple interest is equal to PTR by 100. So this is the, so make note of these points.